So are you like this guy? He's wondering why his business isn't getting found in the search engines. Yet he's registered his business on Google months ago. It feels like everything he's tried has just made no difference at all. To make things worse, he was told it was easy to get found on Google for his business. But if he doesn't get found soon, then his business is going to struggle to survive. Well, you're not alone if you can relate to that. Most business owners have found they've had the same problem. Yet today, this video has been made to change it for you. So in this video, I'm going to reveal all of the mistakes that are commonly made when you've just registered your business on Google Business Profile. And the idea then is you can stop making these mistakes, do the right things, and get your business back on track so it gets found and gets clicks through. So let's start with the first massive mistake, mistake number one. When you registered your business, what did you decide to call the business name as far as Google's profile is concerned? What did you register it under? Well, if you didn't register it as the name of your business in the real world, you may suddenly find you receive a suspension. Now you can fall into three camps here, and two of those three will eventually suspend your business. So you could say you're on borrowed time if you've not done the right one of these three. So as a business owner, which of these three are you? Are you A, my business name is the name of my business in the real world, it's on my headed paper, it's on my website, in fact, everywhere you see my business, it's consistent, that business name's consistent with Google Business Profile too. Or are you B, where you say my business name includes some keywords as well as perhaps having these after the business name, and it's because I heard it might just help rank it slightly. Or are you business C, where you just let an SEO guru do what he wanted? He said that by putting loads of keywords in on your business name, you'll find that it brings in lots of traffic, and maybe initially it did do that for you. Well, which one of those is going to succeed long term? A, B, or C? Well, it's A. B and C, if they're not suspended already, they will get suspended, because they break or they violate the policy guidelines that Google's been very clear about for many years. And by having those extra keywords either after or before your business name, your real business name, you do get an advantage in the search engines. The algorithm rewards those keywords and you will find it has a big impact. But that isn't going to be rewarded forever, because ultimately Google's aware of it, it sees it as breaking the policies, and as soon as someone reports it, you'll find that you've suddenly got a suspension. So the biggest mistake of a business name is people are thinking more about what the search engine wants rather than what real people want. And in fact, it is quite off-putting if you get a business name with so many keywords in and it's clearly not the business. So actually, long-term, think about the real business name. Don't look for quick fixes and quick gains and you'll be rewarded. So that's mistake number one. Now, mistake number two is probably the most common and the biggest mistake that people are currently making. And if I'm honest, I think Google made the mistake before you did. And that's to do with whether you're a service or a shop. And ultimately, it's connected to do with your address itself. To be honest, many business owners work from home, and so they don't want their personal address appearing. But others have a shop, or others go out to customers. What about the ones that perhaps have a shop and go to customers? Are they a shop or are they a service? Well, Google was never that clear at the beginning as to what it expected. It's now revised its policies and it's now very clear, but it's quite complicated. So in a very simple way, I'm going to try and explain it to you today. Just to say, because of the complexity, if you did want to go a bit deeper into this, then there was a video that I produced that was called Why You Should Hide Your Address on Google Maps. And so if you want to view that video, then I'll put a link above it now, and you can go onto that after this video. Simply put, you need to have your real world business address, and then you can choose whether or not you show it. So that's down to you, that's your choice. So you may want to show it, you can switch it, you can toggle that on and off now. That's a new setting on Google Business Profile. But you can't use PO boxes or mailboxes or virtual addresses. It has to be a physical address that's owned by you, that you can serve and you can receive post at. So many have taken mailboxes or PO boxes and they've tried to register businesses with that. Google is not accepting it. It's very clear about that too. If Google finds that out, it will probably suspend you. And then you need to understand the difference between a shop and a service. So there's a helpful tutorial here that Google gives you. So you can follow that link. I'll put it down below as well, so you can see where to go to for that answer. And then also you need to understand that within the service area, there are two areas. There's a service area and there's also a hybrid service area. So you have this debate, are you a shopfront or are you a service area? So no wonder the guy's confused when it comes to his business. Now, this guy actually owns an auto repair shop. Does he act as a service? Because he goes down in his breakdown lorry and he goes down and helps people with their cars at their addresses. So he services areas, but he also has his own garage where he does MOTs and where he does repairs, and people can come off the streets and take their car to him. So can you see how that would be difficult to know? Are you a shop? Are you a service? And in that situation, you're a hybrid service. So that's a good example of why hybrid would work for many businesses today. So mistake number three is all about photos. And photos do serve a large part when it comes to your Google business profile, because we're visual creatures, then your logo, your photos, your videos have a big impact on how you're perceived and the strength of your branding. But let's play a quick game as to whether you fully understand how Google is rewarding and using photos in the algorithm today. Now, three of these statements are false, and one of these statements is true. So I want you to work out which one of these four statements is true. And then when you know what it is, put that letter down below in the comments, and then you'll know afterwards whether you got it right or wrong. So are you ready? So statement A, geotagging photos is still important. So is that true or false? What about B, Google photos need text on the image to help Google understand what they're about. Is that true or false? C, adding your logo is a good idea as it increases brand awareness to the photo. And D, genuine unique photos are often not approved for no reason. So one of those four expressions is true and the other three are false. So I'll give you the answer in a moment. You've got a chance to pause the video now, put your comment down below, then come back to the video. Well, your photos can make or break the traffic to your video. If you look at your photos and see the views it's produced, you may be surprised that certain videos seem to be thrown around in the algorithm and they do bring in a lot of traffic to your business. So get it right and you will see constant traffic coming in to your Google business profile. And the fact is Google totally understands photos. But it's also fair to say that even the SEO advice that was given just a few years ago on Google business profile, it doesn't always mean it rings true. In fact, a lot's changed on photos over the past few years. So that video of me talking about geotagging, that video is no longer current because Google now no longer respects the geotagging on photos. So what did you put for the comment down below? Did you put A, B, C or D as being the only true statement? Well, let's take the statement A first of all, if you put that. Mention a geotagging photos is still important, and I said it was. Well, that's an old video, and that's not true. That's false. Studies have shown that Google no longer uses geotagging of the photos because it was misused, so Google can't rely on it any longer. Okay, what about B then? Was it B? Google Photos needs text on the image to help Google understand what it is. Well, that's false. Again, that's not true. Google has an incredible built-in AI to know exactly how the image should be interpreted. It doesn't need text any longer. It understands the majority of objects that are on an image. So if you don't believe that, you can drag and drop any images into this Google AI, this vision, where it's got a drag and drop. Again, I'll put the link down below, and that will tell you what Google thinks it is. And 9 times out of 10, it's very, very close to being fully accurate as to what the picture's about. So the AI doesn't need text to understand what is in an image. What about C then? Adding your logo is a good idea. It increases brand awareness. We know a few months ago I would have said that was true. That's now false again. Why? Because Google has just changed its policies. It now doesn't like anything duplicated in a photo. So the chances are if you've got the logo appearing constantly in all your photos, Google won't like that. And it may well then say that it won't accept those images. So duplicate content in photos, if it knows your photos have been used elsewhere, if it knows those photos are stock photos, that's definitely a no-no. Lots of things there that come under duplicate content of a photo now. So you just want a unique photo. Don't add your logo other than the logo photo that you add once for your profile. So if you put D in the comments, then you were right, because that was the only true statement. Genuine unique photos are often not approved for no reason. And this is true because the spam filter has just got a lot stricter. And if you want examples of this, look at these poor innocent businesses. These are genuine businesses They're uploading good photos, unique photos, and yet, as you can see here, Google's rejecting them, not approving them. Why? Because the algorithm and the spam filters are so strict at the moment. And so that's the only thing to be aware of, is you may have to upload several photos before one gets accepted. But that was the true statement D. Now, on our next mistake, James Clear is going to help us to decide how we can go about fixing that mistake. And it's one of the easiest things to fix. And so far, this video has given you two or three other videos that you'll need to watch at some point. So why not subscribe so you don't miss any of those future videos that I release too, that is going to help you build your business so it's more stable and gets more calls coming through in the future. So mistake number four is all about keeping regularly updated. Now, how is James Clear going to help us in this case? And who is James Clear? Well, James Clear wrote a book quite recently called Atomic Habits. He made some very interesting statements about just small 1% gains here and there, building very small little habits in your life to get an improved outcome or output in the future. And that's a little bit about how Google Business Profile works, that just those little small constant tweaks can make a large difference in your ranking just in a few months later. He states in his book, Atomic Habits, that habits seem to make little difference on any given day, and yet the impact that they deliver over the months and years can be enormous. And I think most people would agree with that statement, but of course, how does that apply itself to mistake number four? Well, Google is a hungry algorithm. It has a database that wants constant updates. It wants to be fed with your hours, your holidays, changes. When Google makes a change, it wants you to respond. And so you could say it's a bit like a Tamagotchi.
Ready for delicious food, great tunes, stunning gifts.
Well, you've got to keep feeding it. It's hungry, it's constantly needing just a bit of nurturing. Now, it doesn't take a lot, but it's that consistency, and it's those signals that can make the difference between you being in the top 10, top 20, or actually being in the top 3 and really seeing the traffic come through to your business. And it can be done quite easily with just a few little tweaks and changes. And going back to what James Clear said, he suggested just a small tweak, a small change, a little habit change. And one of the things I've used in recent times is when I open up my browser window, I have several windows that open up. And one of those windows is the registration or the management page to my business. And that will then tell me whether everything's updated. And at least once a week, Google will request one or two little things. So what I do is before I close that browser window, I just update it. So if it needs a new photo, I'll update a new photo. If it wants me to get reviews, I'll ask for a couple of reviews elsewhere. If it wants me to respond to a chat or a message, I can do that. But by just clicking on those things and following the process, Google goes, yeah, this person, he's feeding his algorithm. He's feeding the database. He's putting in information in there. And these are signals where Google goes, this business is up to date. It's responsive. It's current. It's alive. It knows what it's doing. Let's promote it. And that's an easy gain. And it's a common mistake. People forget. They think, well, I'll update it. And until 3 months go by, and you're not currently up to date any longer. So that was an easy mistake to fix. Just update your browser so it automatically opens up on the right page. But the next mistake is a trap that most people fall into. And it's such an important one to be aware of. It's to do with reviews. You know, every other email I receive through my business and through my YouTube channel is saying about the importance of reviews. And they're saying that they're upset because maybe someone left them a poor review. Or obviously there's also the issue of people giving reviews when they don't actually have your services. And of course, this is a really important area to consider. But the bit that I want to concentrate on is the fact that most people think that the ranking of where your business appears locally is based on the reviews. It's almost like they're thinking that if you've got lots of 5-star reviews, you're at the top. And if you've got lots of 1-star reviews, you're at the bottom. And if you've got 4 or 3 or 2, then you're somewhere in the middle. Well, do we really believe that Google's got such a simple algorithm? There are over 200 things it takes into account to decide on where someone ranks. And understanding what those 200 things is a challenge for most people. So people need to stop believing that Google is using reviews as the only method of ranking. In fact, I would say that probably only about 2% of the algorithm is based on exactly the stars, whether it's 1 to 5. That in itself is just one part of it. There's so much more. In fact, Google Business Profile only makes up about 35% of the local SEO algorithm. The thing is if reviews were even the bulk of the Google Business Profile algorithm and ranking method, the fact that only 35% of it is used anyway implies there's 65% that we still need to understand. And that's why I made this really simple video that's going to help you understand what else is included in that 65%. So make sure you watch that video next so it gives your business a massive boost in the coming months.